Welcome back to episode 3 of the series, where I'll be looking through Premier League programs from this season and each month using them as inspiration to help you guys build your skill set in InDesign. These tips will help you create your own artwork, which you can then bring to life with print. In the last episode, I went through the Brighton program and showed you how to create image grids and use character styles to create highlighted text. In this episode, I'll be going over the West Ham program and I'll be showing you how to create paragraph styles, use text wrap, and create page numbers. So let's begin by creating a style for the questions and the answers to help make my copy more digestible. Right now, it just does look like a lump of text, and I couldn't imagine wanting to read this. It does look very boring. So begin by going to Window, Styles, Paragraph Styles, or using the shortcut F11. A tab like this will open, and in this tab, just select the plus icon in the bottom right corner, create a new style, and it will create Paragraph Style 1. Before we select Paragraph Style 1, you need to highlight a word from the paragraph you would like to change. So I'll highlight the word here, and just double click Paragraph Style 1, and it will open a tab like this. I'll quickly show you the basics, as I'll move on to more advanced stuff in a second. So head to Basic Character Formats, and this is where you change the style of the actual font itself. So I want my font to be Proxima Nova. I want it to be bold. And I want the size of it to be 9 points, so that all the copy will fit. And I'd also like to change the colour to cyan, just so that it stands out from the actual answers themselves. I'm just going to click OK. So now that I've created the style for my questions, I'm going to create a style for my answers. Same as before, go ahead and create a new style and open it up. I'll quickly create the basic format and show you some more tips. So as you can see, I've created my basic format, but now let's move on to indents and spacing. Indents and spacing help you control text alignment, indentation, and line spacing. You should be able to see an alignment dropdown. In this menu, you'll have all the alignment options. You have the most common three, left, center, and right. And you also have justified alignment. Justified alignment increases the space between words to fill the entire line so that it is both aligned to the left and right of the column. So if I was to click left justify, you would see that it creates a straight line on the edge of either side of the column. And this is the same for right justify and center justify. In my case, I'm just going to do left align, and I'm going to tick the box balance ragged lines. Balanced ragged lines help it keep a nice flush look without making it look too robotic and almost perfect. Now let's move on to the indents. You either have your left indent or your right indent. This just moves the text away from the column. So the left indent moves it away from the right left side, and the right indent moves it away from the right side. As you can see, when I moved it to 4 millimeters, it pushed the text slightly into the right. However, I don't want to worry about this, so I'm just going to leave it on 0. Then you have your first line indent. You see this when there's lots of copy. It just is a good way of showing a new paragraph. However, again, I've got enough space to show that there's a paragraph, so I don't necessarily need it in this case. You can have space before. This is the distance of the gap, and space after will be the distance of the gap at the bottom of the paragraph. However, I'm happy with the default 0 millimeters. You also have paragraph rules. This acts as a divider between each paragraph. I've got my questions to help as a divider, but I'll go ahead and show you how it works. If I click rule on, as you can see, a line has been created through my paragraph. If I offset it so that it goes just above, you can see, and I can change from the left where the line begins and from the right where the line begins to create a nice divider. However, as I said before, I put my question as my divider, so this is not necessary for me. You also have a border which you can create if I just tick this box. It's completely customizable. You can change the width of the stroke. You can even change the corners of the box like this. You can also offset the box so there is space around it. However, I don't want a border, so I'm going to untick the box. Hyphenation is definitely one you need to consider when working on a paragraph style. You need to consider the audience and who will be reading this. In this case, this section of the program is aimed towards children, and children find it hard to read hyphenated text. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to untick the box, but you can also, if you want to keep hyphens, you can also limit the amount of hyphens there are by customizing these options here. However, as I said before, I don't want hyphens at all, so I'm just going to untick the box. I'm also going to leave my character color black as it's on a white background. And that's me done. So now if I click OK, and if I highlight this, just this here, click answers, as you can see, it's created that paragraph style. So now that I've created my paragraph styles, I'm going to add a couple images to go along with the text and show you how to create a text wrap so they sit nicely and flow well with the copy. So I've added my images of a pizza and the player doing a knee slide as he talks about eating pineapple pizza in the first paragraph, and then he talks about a celebration in the last paragraph of the left column. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to make them sit nicely with the copy. With the pizza selected, go to Window, select Text Wrap, and a tab like this should appear. So in this tab, what I want to do is I want to select Wrap Around Object Shape. And now these options down here should be available. And I want to go to Contour Options and select Subject, and InDesign should be able to detect where the subject is and create an outline like it has done here. So now if I move this within the text, as you can see, it fits nice and perfect. However, some of the copy is going within the image itself. So what I want to do is just expand the border slightly so it sits nice and follows around the edge of the shape. And you can change it to wrap to the right side, left side, both sides, side towards the spine, which would be the left side as the spine is in the center, side away from the spine, which would be the right side, and then the largest area. However, I'm just going to do both sides as this copy either side, and I don't want it to look awkward. Finally, I'm going to show you how to add page numbers. So what you want to do is open your Pages tab and select your parent page. So just double click on this here. And as you can see, it should open up empty like this. And this parent page overrides any other page within your design. That's how it works. So now I've got this parent page open, I'm going to head to my layers. I'm going to create a new layer and call it page numbers. Just that, so that it sits on top of all my other design. And in this layer, what I want to do is I want to get my type tool, just draw a square here, and just type a number. Just type number one. Highlight this number, go to type, insert special character, markers, current page number. And it should turn to a letter A like this. And now I can just hold Alt or Option if you're on a Mac, and just duplicate it over here. And now if I go to Pages and just go back to this page, as you can see, the page number has been sorted. However, it slightly clashes on this, the cyan. It works, but let's say I'd rather have a white one. All I have to do is highlight these two parent pages and then just duplicate the spread. And then what I can do is highlight the page number, make it white, go back to this page, right click it, apply parent pages, and select B parent. And as you can see, it makes the number white. We do have a video on our channel which goes more in depth about page numbers if you'd like to follow that. Thanks for watching, and in the next episode I'll be going for the Brentford program, so don't forget to stay tuned to see that.